Well, here it is. We finally got the pump that we've been calling for so long on this channel. Now, the real question is this going to have any substance, or is it going to collapse like all the ones we've had over the last couple months? Let's go ahead and dive in, and I'm going to tell you exactly what to look for, so don't go anywhere. Let's get into it. So this is the Ethereum chart. And as you guys can see, there are a few reasons as to why we did get a pump on this chart. So the first thing, you have this very clear 8-hour breaker that was established. You can see that because you have an increase in price, a decrease, which is where the bears fought back, and a continuation of the upside. Since this was the area of contention, you would imagine it to also provide support on the way back down. And you guys can see we had wicks into it, but we never actually closed inside of it or even barely dropped underneath it. But realistically, this level held up like a champ. Furthermore, another thing you're looking for is this bullish reaction. You guys can see how you have the lower lows on price and you have the higher lows on RSI. This is a bullish divergence that played out absolutely beautifully on the 8-hour chart. It played on other charts as well, but this is very, very clear here. Now, if you go to the 4-hour chart, you guys can see this as well. This is on the log chart, and this is a falling trend line that was established on Ethereum. Well, between the 8-hour breaker, between the bullish divergence, and because of the falling trend line, you guys can see we did actually get a pretty hefty bounce to the upside. Now, let's look at the volume on here. And volume is one of the main things you're looking for anytime you're trying to see if a breakout has any substance. Well, so far, the volume profile looks pretty healthy. We have a very strong, healthy candle when we broke out of this trend line. And now we have some consolidation with lower volume. Overall, I like what I'm seeing so far. However, it's still very early and we have to be careful, guys. We have to be careful. We do not have any confirmation that it's going to continue. So what am I looking for the confirmation? Well, for one, we are still heavily inside of this daily breaker. And this daily breaker needs to get broken through, retested, or at least a daily close above here. So that's the first thing I'm looking for. I believe on the 8-hour, 4-hour, there it is. On the 4-hour chart, you have this massive consolidation of resistance right here, right? So this entire block is a daily resistance. However, the most important resistance is where we're at right now. So we really want to see a 1 hour or 4 hour close above this mass consolidation to really give us some more confirmation that we are going to continue going up. Now, the next level of contention we're going to have is right here. This is going to be the 4 hour 200 moving average, as well as this daily breaker block. This is the point of breakdown. It's a mass, just consolidation of price action, right? And so anytime you have a mass consolidation of price action like that, you're going to assume it's going to have a lot of issue getting back above it. On the 3-day, it's even more clear. You guys can see this very clear breaker that's going to provide a lot of resistance on the way down. Now, if we get above there, I think we have a lot of we have a very high chance of continuing to the upside in a really, really big way. However, one step at a time, guys, okay? One step at a time. So on Ethereum, that's what I'm looking for. Now on Bitcoin, we have a similar situation that also happened. Let me find the clean chart I'm looking for. This is the one I'm looking for. Perfect. So I cleared it up and got rid of all the extra stuff we don't need. On here, we have a pretty clear and defined falling wedge, okay? I need to fix this, actually. Oh, the log chart's on. That's why. There we go. Clearly defined falling wedge. So from point to point, we had this massive bull trap. We had a little bit of is this the right one? I think I'm actually missing it, aren't I? Oh, different chart. I'm so sorry, guys. Let me fix that real quick. This is a falling wedge I'm looking for. Much better. So lower time frame, but either way. So as you guys can see, we had this point extended out, and it came back down, retested it, and continued to the upside. So, and on the bottom, we have that. Now, so this falling wedge did break out from, and on this chart, the one we were just on, there we are. On this one, we have this a lot bigger falling wedge, okay? And this bigger falling wedge is something I'm actually taking a lot of interest in right now. You do see, although it doesn't look very good on the 1 hour,
if you go to a higher time frame, you can see these two lines are absolutely converging, right? So we do have a series of lower highs and lower lows, but they are coming into a central apex, which means that we are losing strength, or we are losing downward pressure to the downside. Falling wedges, as you probably know, they do generally break up to the upside. So that's what I really want to see here. I think that if we can hold this 4-hour breaker, which originally held us up at this point, and we had all this consolidation, if we can stay above this daily breaker, I think then our next level of target is going to be this daily breaker right here. We get above this daily, then we're going to be testing this top level, this top side of our falling wedge. And if we're able to bust above this falling wedge, we're going to have a lot of strength to the upside. Okay. This is when all of those things that I talked about in my 8 reasons why I'm still really bullish on Bitcoin, I'll make sure to put a card up right now. Okay. Make sure to watch that video, because all of those high time frame things I talk about in that chart is still absolutely valid, guys. The bullish divergences, the Wyckoff accumulation schematic, the 3-strike pattern, the negative funding, all those different things are still 100% valid. And if we do bust out of this falling wedge, I think it's going to get extremely aggressive to the upside. And yes, a continuation of the bull run is likely at that point. So one step at a time, all right? So you guys now know what to expect on the low time frame, okay? This is the next 24 to 48 hours. That's what you need to be looking for. I'll be making update videos over on the next 48 hours or so to keep you guys in the know, right? Also, make sure you're following me on Twitter. Make sure you're following me on Discord so I can get you guys even more up-to-date information, okay? I do post on there all the time about it. So that's basically all I got. Like always, if you have any questions, let me know. I'm going to end the video now, and I will see you in the next video. So, deuces, boys.